Okay, now we have discussed the concept of balloonets, but at the moment let us assume there are no balloonets, which means you have a simple envelope which has got nothing inside. So the volume occupied by the gas is equal to the volume of the envelope. In this case, the gross lift will be basically weight of the air, which is rho A, density of the air, into V E N V. Now I will use this symbol V E N V throughout for envelope volume, and G will be the acceleration due to gravity. So what will be the units of LG in SI system? It will be newtons. Now this is one mistake which many students will make, so it's important for me to caution you right now. By a simple check of units, where rho is kg per meter cube, v is meter cube, and g is meter per second square, you will find that it is going to come in newtons. Okay, so be very careful. I keep warning people, but people keep committing this mistake because they are in a hurry. They don't look at the units at every point in this calculations. Units have to be confirmed. So the force Lg acting will be rho a into v and v into g. This is the gross static lift, and the net static lift will be the gross static lift minus the weight of the lifting gas. Any doubts? This is straightforward. Therefore, the weight of the lifting gas can be assumed to be rho g into V E and V into g. So the difference between them. So then we come up with the simplest formula, the most basic formula which you will use throughout your calculations, and that is the net lift which is available from any LTS system is the difference in the density between the ambient air and the gas volume times envelope volume into g, assuming that the entire envelope space is occupied by the lifting gas. But this is never the case except under one condition. So which is the operating condition at which this formula is perfectly applicable? For a typical airship, what is the operating condition at which this formula is correctly applicable? At the ceiling, at the now the altitude at which this thing happens, that means at the altitude at which the LTA gas occupies the entire volume, that altitude is when the balloonets are completely flush. That happens at the ceiling, and this altitude is called as the pressure height. So this is an important term which you can note down. Pressure height is the altitude at which the balloonets are flush, if present, and the complete volume occupied by the lifting gas is there in the full end. Also the full envelope, the envelope is fully occupied by the lifting gas, there is no balloon air. Above this altitude, it is not very easy to go, you have to resort to dumping of the gas or some other measures. Okay. Now we know that a typical airship has balloonets. We have seen last time why we give balloonets. Okay. Do you remember what is the purpose of balloonets? Correct. So to control the buoyancy, to control its equilibrium. And is that the only reason? For pitch control. And any other reason? Yeah, angle of attack basically is pitch only. Giving angle of attack means allowing it to pitch. One more important purpose is to relieve the stresses on the envelope. So from structural considerations, if you don't provide balloon and if you take it to very high altitude, then the delta P between inside and outside, outside pressure will keep falling, inside will remain same. Therefore, there will be a huge amount of tear. So by using balloon, you are giving lesser or more volume for the same LTA gas, and thus you relieve the pressure. So pressure control, buoyancy control, and trim, these are the three reasons why we have one or many balloon. So now, if you have a situation which is most typical situation for a manned airship at least, is that you will have one or many balloons filled with air. So you define a term called as the infraction fraction. Okay, it's a very funny name, infraction fraction. And that is fraction of the envelope occupied by the LTA gas. So 1 minus I will be fraction of the gas occupied by the balloon. So the value of I in fraction fraction will be 0 to 1. It will be 1 if there are no balloon, or if you are at pressure height, it may be 0.8, 0.7. Typically the balloon volume tends to be around 20-25% of the envelope volume, but this is not a fixed number. This number has to be calculated by you based on how much delta H you would like to provide, from which height you will operate and up to what height you will go. These important parameters determine the amount of balloon volume that you need to provide. Okay. So if there is air in the gas bag, then the net lift will not be equal to LG minus WLG, gross lift minus the lifting gas weight. There will be one more term to be subtracted, which is the weight of the air in the balloon. We call it the WBA. And WBA will be volume of the balloon at that particular condition times the density of air, which will be same as density of air outside. Because a balloon is always in contact with the ambient air, it takes air from outside. However, at various altitudes, when it takes in air, it will have different density compared to say sea level. So note that WLG, that is the weight of the lifting gas. Now all these items you are not supposed to just see on the board and nod your head. You are supposed to note down, because very soon you will be deriving expressions to use it. Okay. So it's not a good idea to just watch. It's a good idea to, I see some students are doing it, just note down these expressions, because the equation will become very, very complicated after a few slides. So weight of the lifting gas will be density of the gas into I into VENV, where I is the infraction fraction, times G, and weight of the air in the balloon will be 1 minus I into VENV times G. The pressure inside the balloon is very slightly more than outside to maintain its shape. So you can assume it to be roughly same as outside, because there is a direct communication through a fan or through a injector. Okay. Correct, but those valves are freely opening valves, so the pressure is communicated. Okay. So the balloon is normally in touch with the atmosphere, so the pressure inside the balloon will be roughly the same as outside, unless you close the whole system and then you push pump air inside, then the pressure will change. So the simple formula of net lift with the presence of balloon, it just gets slightly modified with this infraction fraction I. So it becomes density of air minus density of gas times I minus rho BA into 1 minus I into VNV into G. So with this you can calculate the net. So if someone tells you that an airship has 20% balloon A and the volume is 1000 meter cube and it is operating at some altitude with helium, so you know rho G at that altitude, you know rho A at that altitude, infraction fraction is given. You can easily calculate the net lift that will be available, and this net lift is meant for you to utilize. So the payload will be this net lift minus the self weight, right? So net lift is what vertical force this whole system is going to give you. You can use that force to carry payload, but you will have some weight of the gondola, fins and other things, so that is a dead weight. So the payload available, or I should say fuel plus payload or useful load, will be net lift minus system weight, and you can trade off that between fuel and payload. And remember, you also have to also carry some ballast. So ballast, as I said, removable ballast, fixed ballast, jettisonable ballast, all of them are going to be part of the empty weight. Some of which you can throw, some of which you can temporarily adjust, some of which will remain fixed for center of gravity control. But they will all be part of the empty weight. You have to carry that much.